aftermarket soft OLED screens that support IC transfer for iPhone 15 Pro are now available. In this video, we'll demonstrate the touch IC transfer to an iPhone 15 Pro aftermarket screen. Let's disassemble the phone. Before transferring the IC, copy the True Tone data to the aftermarket screen. Connect the original screen to a programmer to read the True Tone data. iPhone 15 Pro and Pro Max share the same connector with iPhone 14 Pro and Pro Max. Connect the aftermarket screen to the programmer. Choose third party to write in the True Tone data. Install the aftermarket screen to verify the True Tone function. Still, the display unknown part message remains. The next step is to remove the display IC from the original screen. Pry up the display flex cable. Insert a heat insulation pad to protect the original screen. Apply captain tape around the IC to prevent heat damage to the screen. Set the hot air gun temperature to 280 degrees Celsius and airflow to 60. Heat the IC evenly with the nozzle 1 cm away for about 6 to 10 seconds. Apply some middle temperature solder paste to ball the IC. Form the solder balls with hot air gun at 280 degrees Celsius. A tag-on flex is needed to solder the IC to the aftermarket screen. The tag-on flex comes with the screen. Apply some flux to the soldering pad of the tag-on flex. Remove the tins from the tag-on flex soldering pad using braid and a soldering iron at 390 degrees Celsius. Apply some flux to the tag-on flex soldering pad. Align the IC with the tag-on flex. Solder the IC to the tag-on flex with hot air gun at 280 degrees Celsius and airflow 60. Apply some middle temp solder wire to the soldering points of the tag-on flex. Clean the flux residue with PCB cleaner. Remove the release liner on the back of the soldering pad. Pry up the display flex cable of the replacement screen. Insert a heat insulation pad to protect the replacement screen. Solder the tag on flex to the screen soldering points with soldering iron at 390 degrees Celsius. Clean the flux residue with cotton. Cover it with a protection sticker. Next, install the aftermarket screen. The IC does not interfere with the screen installation fitment. True tone is restored. The screen is fully functional. The unknown part display message is gone. IC transplant can be challenging and may risk screen damage. Leave us a comment if you have any question about IC transplant. The parts, tools, and consumables used in the video are listed in the description section. Thank you for watching.